Oh, it's Guild Wars Purple Day teams you're after? Guild Wars Purple Day strategy you want? This is your video. Let's jump in and figure out what the heck everything is on Purple Day. Let's go! First team we're going to look at here is the Slamajama. Since we're using Frostmage, every single time you loop with this team, your Doomscythe is going to be doing more damage, so that's always cool. And then Glaceon is able to do crap ton of Doomskull damage. The weapon with the Doomscythe is able to do a crap ton of skull damage. The one thing to be aware of is that Glaceon basically turns all the yellows that you want for your Doomscythe into blues. And Doomscythe is going to sit there and just kind of work by itself. So Glaceon and these Doomscythe aren't exactly working together perfectly. However, the nice thing about having Possessed King in this team is that whenever you kind of take away the mana color that you want, in this case the yellows with Glaceon, whenever everything explodes, Possessed King's gonna make sure that the board looks nothing like it did before, so you will have opportunity to still do your Doomscythe cast after this. But basically you're just trying to cast these two whenever it makes sense, and then use Shabanu whenever you can't. And this team should be able to light up pretty much everything since the damage output is absolutely crazy, especially so if you're able to use Shabanu to pop up either the attack on Glaceon or the magic on your Doomscythe. You should shred anything you come in contact with. It's also nice because you do get a free start, which is always super useful in PvP. So this team, super strong, super nice. Let's move on. This next team is the Torchum. This is what you use when the other team doesn't care about red mana and they also have no immunity to burning. This team is going to literally rip people to shreds. Since all of the mana we're making here is yellow between Divine Ishbala and Moonrabbit, and Doomscythe is able to take all of the yellows and turn them into Doomskulls, Divine Ishbala is able to just take all the reds that are dropping from the sky and turn them into skulls, and we have a sneaky way of creating yellow with both of these. This team is actually really, really effective on Purple Day, as this team basically doesn't care about purple mana at all, they just all happen to be purple. So this team also extremely lethal. This team can literally shred the entire team in one cast of Divine Ishbala or one cast of Doomscythe if you get the right kind of alignment. This team can literally destroy everybody on the other team one turn if you line it up just right. Either way, it's still super lethal, super potent, and Moonrabbit's there at least to bless your first troop if you so need. Super fun, let's move on. If you thought one Grey King was good, how about a double? Make it a double. Double Grey King. Daughter of Ice is here to basically force a Ice Storm, which is super fun, and then Grey King and Possessed King take over from there. You're just going to be looping like wild. Whenever you cast Grey King, you're going to disable the other team a crap ton, so with this team, you're able to poke at life and death teams if you so desire. They have any kind of common mana being shared across everyone. They're also going to get picked apart super easy. And on top of all that, you're getting tons and tons and tons of stat pumping with double Grey King going on, plus 4 magic every single time. Extremely strong, extremely potent. This team is really fun to use, and it involves double Grey King, which is the coolest meta that's ever existed in PvP ever. That's that team, let's move on. This team is kind of an extension of a few that we've seen before. This is using Doomscythe with Shaba and Divine and Moonrabbit, so the idea here is exactly the same as the previous ones. We're running this with Priest class so we get a 40% mana start on our Doomscythe, but the synergy here between Doomscythe and Divine Ishbala and Moonrabbit is still incredibly strong, and the nice thing with this team is that the mana you're going to make is more often than not going to be useful to you, as the blues that get made are useful for Moonrabbit, the yellows that get made are useful for Moonrabbit and Divine Ishbala, and the weapon. And so all of this stuff works really, really nicely together. You can run this with other classes if you so choose, I just prefer to have a slightly faster mana start. And the ability to self-cleanse never hurts, even though you have Moonrabbit running this thing. But again, the amount of lethal skull damage that you're going to be doing is just absolutely wild. So this team, also super fun, and destructive, and amazing. This team actually takes advantage of the Herophant class. And no, this is not a joke, Herophant is actually required. The Summer Aegis weapon requires a mixed type of a specific group of people, and Herophant just happens to be one of them. So this will make you a mix of green and red mana, so Queen Titania is happy, Suna is happy. Leprechaun, when you pop them off, there's going to be a Firestorm start, so that's going to get you a ton of reds to start things off. Hopefully you get your Summer Aegis up and running, and then you just kind of blam people with Queen Titania and Suna. It is deceptively powerful since there's so much Fairy Fire on this team. One cast of Queen Titania and one cast of Suna is usually enough to kill two people. So this team, very, very lethal, surprisingly, and you get to use Hero Fan. So everybody wins? Question mark? This final team is a little bit of a loose cannon, but it is absolutely fun and pretty darn destructive. This is using the Orpheusverse weapon, which is making a mixed type based on humans, and every single person in this lineup is a human. So we have access to Cleanse, we have access to Skulls, we have access to Looping. Since we're running this with War Priest, we also have access to Enraged Skull Hits every single time we do a 4-5 match. The amount of looping that this team is going to do will mean you're pretty much enraged literally every second of the fight. This team will be incredibly powerful, incredibly strong. The one thing that makes this a little bit of a wild card is the weapon. Since it is a mixed type weapon, you have no idea if you're going to create a bunch of great stuff for yourself, or you're going to set them up for something super terrible. The other problem with this is that the mana that it makes is yellow and blue. The yellow part's amazing, but the blue part is more or less wasted on this team. We don't care about filling Possessed King, but it still loops incredibly well regardless. So this team is something else that you can be using very, very safe against certain lineups, but also a little bit dangerous since the mixed type weapons aren't as dependable. But another option for you if you so desire for Purple Day. And here is your huge list of all the stuff that you need to worry about for Purple Day Guild Wars. So across the top for the classes, we have the Frostmage, Priest, Sunspear, Titan, and War Priest. For the weapons, we've got our Doomscythe, our Jack-O-Lantern, Orpheusverse, Summer Aegis, Titania's Fan, and Elemental Bow. For our Empowered Converters, we've got Moonrabbit, Daughter of Ice, Drowned Sailor, and Fist of Zorn. And then for the supports, we've got our Voice of Orpheus, Herdmaster, Possessed King, and Azora. And then for our damagey folks, we got Glaceon, Nemu, Infernal King, Divine Ishbala, Obsidius, Infernus, Wild Queen, the Grey King, Arachnian Weaver, Shabanu, Queen Titania, and Queen Mab. The first class of the Frostmage, the thing you want to think about with Frostmage is, do I need to freeze somebody at the start of my turn, as well as do I need to potentially continuously freeze? Beyond all of that, you get your 50% mana start, which is great, and you want to be running a lineup that is looping as consistently as possible, so converting type troops are your best bet. So if you're going to be running a Frostmage, my recommendation would be trying to use conversion type weapons, so Doomscythe fits very nicely, Moonrabbit, Daughter of Ice, Drowned Sailor, and Fist of Zorn all fit nicely. Glaceon, Nemu, Infernal King, and Ishbala all fit super nice, but pretty much every single troop that's on this entire list will loop in some capacity. So more consistent looping is better, but looping in general is obviously great. Make sure you're controlling the storm if at all possible, and win your fight. Next up, if we're going to be looking at the Priest class, there's a couple things that we definitely want to look at. First and foremost is Divine Ishbala. Since Divine Ishbala is going to get our Priest class 40% mana start, those two are like peas and carrots, you put them together. Beyond all of that, you're almost certainly going to be using Moonrabbit, since Moonrabbit is going to get you a bunch of yellows right at the start. So right away with the Priest class, we've got Divine Ishbala and Moonrabbit. From there, it's really just a matter of putting whatever else in that team you think makes the most sense. If you're looking to do tons of damage, you could throw a Doomscythe in there. If you're looking to do some other kinds of utility things, you could throw in other troops. But most certainly, if you're running a Priest class, Divine Ishbala and Moonrabbit will be on that team. Next up, we've got ourselves the Sunspear. And Sunspear is all about doing burning triple skull damage. If you're going to be running a Sunspear class on PvP times, it's going to be doing triple skull damage, meaning you do want burning, meaning you want Infernus. So Infernus is going to be your best friend. Infernus is divine type, so pairing him up with Divine Ishbala makes a ton of sense to be your skull converter. She also converts into yellows, which helps Infernus as well. Beyond all of that, it's really just a matter of putting whomever else on that team you think you're going to need. If you need some cleansing, you can throw in Voice of Orpheus. Since you're going to have tons of yellows on the board, you're going to be constantly cleansed, so that's obviously a super sweet combo. Since we're running constant firestorms, putting someone like Possessed King can be fun on that team, because every single time you do a match, just more and more and more reds are going to come down from the sky. One of the key things to think about when you're trying to pick a Sunspear is that if you know the other team doesn't care about red mana, Sunspear should immediately jump to your mind as an option. Running a Sunspear guarantees that the board is going to be constantly red, so if it's constantly red and the other team doesn't want red, Sunspear can be a very cool option to take. And of course, if you're just looking to get a ton of yellow mana right at the start, Moonrabbit could also be a sweet option for you. Titan, of course, could work with pretty much any of the lineups that you'd want to throw together with any of these troops. However, something that Titan will naturally do better than some of the others is start with the Dust Storm, which can be very helpful. So brown troops that you might want to pair him up with would be someone like Obsidius with Glaceon, like Wild Queen potentially with Gray King. Those are all options that could help you get a lot of browns going a lot quicker. But beyond all of that, literally just pick any weapon, any troops that you think will fit nicely together, and Titan should do just fine. Rounding out the classes is the War Priest, mainly because the Orpheus Verse weapon is pretty sweet to use. Voice of Orpheus and Divine Ishbala and Possess King are all human, so if you throw them all together, then the Orpheus Verse weapon is pretty great. However, even if you don't want to use the Orpheus Verse weapon, since you have a lot of strong yellow mana generation here with Divine Ishbala in the list, you can just theoretically put her with other skull converters and make something pretty darn useful with War Priest, since they have that natural skull resistance and that bonus yellow mana. But other than that, War Priest probably not your first option. They're mainly in here because the Orpheus Verse weapon exists, and I like it. Finally, if there's a specific troop or weapon that I haven't explicitly talked about in this section of the video, it isn't that they're bad and you shouldn't consider them. It's just that they kind of are loose cannon type things. They're going to fit very specific kinds of lineups, not necessarily being plug and play or mix and match as easily as some of the other troops that I've highlighted here. But all of the troops that you see on this board are all extremely viable, all extremely great, so don't think that I don't love them just because I didn't talk about them now. I just did. I love them all. But hopefully watching this video has given you some sweet ideas on Purple Day teams you could use, or different troops and class and weapon interactions you could potentially consider for your Purple Guild Wars Day fights. This is Keylime signing off. I will see you in a future video. Peace.